Hey everyone, hope you guys are doing well. I'm Shubham and you're watching Let Create an App. So in this video, we will talk about one of the basic topic and we can also say that iOS application architecture pattern, and that is MVC. Basically, MVC stands for Model View Controller, in which model is responsible for storing all the data which is coming from the API, and view is responsible for showing the data. And basically, controller is used to write all the business logic at one place. So these three combinedly called MVC. So as you guys are seeing this image, and in this we are having a model, view and controller. So whenever API get called or some data is coming from some other places, then model fill the data and notify the controller that I am having a data. And when controller get this thing, they update the views accordingly with the new data. And whenever user take any action on this views, then they will handle by the controller. And if there is any kind of data manipulation, then controller will manipulate the data and update the models. So this process is continue working in the MVC pattern. So basically, this is a rough diagram of the thing. If you like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button. And if you're new to the channel, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to get the notifications of all my other videos. So let's start the video. Let's create an app. So now we need to create one project, and I've already created this project. Now we have to install one pod, that is Alarmifier. Basically, Alarmifier is used to do a networking calls between the application and the server on which data is stored. So we are going to use one API, and that is a public API. So this is just like this API we are going to use, and you guys get this API via this wonderful website, that is JSON placeholder. And as you type JSON placeholder on Google, you'll get landed on this page. Click on the first link, and from this website you have to click on this post, and as you click on this post, you landed on this page, and this is a data of 100 people. So you guys get this data in our application, and we are going to show this data in application. So let's move on the application first, and now let's move on the storyboard. So we are going to show the data in the table view. So for that, we have to just simply take one table view, and my Xcode is quite new. That's 11.1. So maybe you face some issues, or maybe the rendering is slow. So these kind of issues can be seen on the screen. Stretch this table view. So just simply give constraints to this table view. So now our table view is placed on the storyboard. Now we have to create one cell. So this is our cell. So we are going to show a title and body part, or you can use any data. It's totally up to you. So I'm going to show title and body in the application. So just move on the application, and we are going to change the table cell style. So this is just like a subtitle thing, because we are going to show two things. So I'm going to use this table style. And one more thing, that if you want to design some custom cell, you can design that custom cell according to your own need. And I've already have a complete series on table view. If you don't know how to populate the table view or how to create a dynamic cells, all the things I've taught in that series, so you guys go and check out that series. The link of that series is mentioned in the description, as well as on the I button. And if you have any difficulty right now, even you guys go and comment so that I can solve all your problems. Now let's move on the view controller. So just click on this thing, and like this. So I think this is a view controller. Yeah, now we have to take the outlets of this view controller, but we are not taking any custom cells, so we are definitely get these things directly in the table view. So let's populate the table view first with the dummy data. So I'm quickly doing this thing. So just create one extension. Okay, yeah, we need to take the outlet of this table view first. So let's move on the controller where this thing. Like this, and just create the outlet of this table view. So table view, like this thing. Now everything is fine. Now let's move on the view controller. Now let's populate the table view. So just simply type extension, and it's good to write all the delegate methods of any kind of thing via in the extension. So simply write extension. This is a view controller extension. So UI table view delegate UI table view data source, like this. These are the two delegate things which we need to implement.
and now it will prompting that we need to install confirm these methods or these protocols. So the number of rows in section, so initially just I'm returning 10 rows like this, and maybe these rows are more, it's totally depend on the number of elements which is coming from the API. So now in the cell forward index path we have to create one cell. So let cell equals to, or we can also use guard let, so that if the cell is not available at that moment, then the application will not get crashed. It simply return the things. Let cell equals to table view dot dq cell with reusable identifier, this method is one in which there are two parameters, the name of the cell as well as the index path, this one. And in this we have to define the name of the cell which we didn't define yet. Now we are going to define that thing, and in the index path we have to simply use index path dot row, simple index path like this. Even I don't think that guard is also required because we are not creating any custom class. If we are creating a custom class, then definitely we need to implement guard statement. Now let's move on the storyboard and give the name to this cell, and I'm just simply writing cell as the name, simply like this. Now let's move on the view controller and simply write cell like this. Now we have to define the values in the cell. Now let's run this thing and check that it is working fine. Before running this thing, we have to confirm the data source and delegate. So simply confirm the data source and delegate. We can also do this thing via coding. So it's totally up to you how you want to do this thing. So the simulator is running and we are getting a 10 rows with all the data which we have filled over here. Now we are going to call an API. So our data population is successfully populated. Now we are going to call an API and fill the data via that API response. So for that we have to create one method for just like function call API. And now we are going to see how this MVC pattern work in this calling process like this. So before calling an API we need to create one model so that we can fill the data in the model. We have to choose this simple swift file and give the name whatever you want to give. I'm just giving data model like this and just save this thing. And now we have to just create one class over here. You can also use struct, it's totally up to you. We also have to need to understand the difference between struct and class, that where we have to use a class and where we have to use a struct. So I'm using data model like this, a simple class. Now we have to define all the things which are coming from the API. So basically these are the four things which are coming from the API. So I'm just copying this thing and pasting over here so that I don't need to move again and again on the web page. So first is user ID like this, and that is of integer type like this. Second is ID, it is also of integer type. I'm creating all these things as an optional so that if there is any key is not coming from the API, then this model will parse successfully, otherwise it will fail if any key is not coming from the API. And the last is body. So making things optional is a quite good process because we can use single model various places, because in some models there are many APIs in which single model is used but some keys are missing. So we can make them optional and use a single model many places. So this is very basic data model, or we can say that a model. And now let's look how complex models can be. So this is very basic model which we are using, but when we are working on a very complex application, then these models are something like this also. So this is really very complex model in which we have media model. In this we are inheriting our data class media, which is also inheriting album. This is a key chaining in which one model is calling a other, and all this kind of a thing. So this is really very complex model. Now let's remove this thing and work on our application like this and save this thing. Now let's move on the view controller, and now let's start writing the API calling. So before that we need to import the alumifier like this, and over here we have to type alumifier like this, and we have to use one method that is request. And we have to use this method. Now we need to pass a URL over here. So for that we have to just copy the URL. So just move on this thing and copy this thing like this. And now we have to paste this thing over here. So it is take a argument as a URL type. So we have to type URL because that is a string which we have just copied, and we have to use one method over here, this string, because we are passing a string over here simply like this. And in the HTTP method, we are this is a post type of a thing, post API. So we have to use a post parameter over here dot post like this. And in the parameter list, we are passing nothing, so just simply pass nil. And in the encoding, we can use default as well as we can remove this thing also. So it's totally up to you what you want to do. So I'm just removing this thing. So just remove this thing, encoding parameter. And in the HTTP header, we are not using any kind of header, so just simply pass nil over here. If this is a login API, then definitely there are many headings which we have to pass. So it's showing that we need to forcefully wrap this thing, this URL. So okay, fine, this is good. Now when this API gets called, it will return a JSON. So we have to simply write request JSON, this one. And in this object, we are getting a data object, and this is a response. So we are getting a response over here. And now we have to typecast this thing. If let response data is equals to response dot data like this. So in this response, we have to get the data like this. Now we have to fill this data in data model, so we can simply populate each and everything via this data model. Now how MVC is working over here is like, this is a view controller, and which is responsible for all the business logics. And as we know that this API calling is also kind of a business logics, so we have just called this API over here, and all the manipulation which we want, we have to do over here. And M is stands for model, and this is a model. This is kind of a M thing, and this is a model which is used to store all the data. And view is our storyboard views in which we have to show the data. So all these three things together makes MVC. So now let's proceed further and just decode this thing. Now let's proceed further and see how we can save this response in the model. So for that, we have to just simply decode the response. So simply write do. We have to use this do catch thing over here for parsing the data, do catch. And now we have to just create one object, decode JSON like this. And we have to use JSON decoder over here like this, an object. And now decode JSON dot strategy, key coding strategy, I guess, key coding strategy. Yeah, and we have to use snack case, this one. And now we have to just save the response in one object. So for that, we have to just create one object over here, like where response array like this. And this should be an array of data model like this, so that we can use this data model to populate the table view. Now we have to use self dot data model, or the name is response array like this. And in this, we have to put try catch, try again, try, and decode JSON dot decode method, this one. And this, we have to pass the data which we want to show. So this is an array of decode model, I guess, data model like this dot self. And in the data, we have to pass the response data, response data, simply like this. After the data is filled, we have to just simply reload the table view to self.tableview.reload. So if we run this thing at this moment, this will not going to work because we didn't call this API over here. So just call this API in view.did.load, and we have to fill that table view. We are using this data model object. So this is showing an error that reference instance required that data model to confirm but decode. Yeah, we didn't confirm this thing to decodable. So we have to confirm this thing to decodable or codable. It's totally up to you. So I'm using codable, this one. Now let's populate the table view. We are using this array. So it's showing one more thing error that, yeah, everything is working fine now. So we have to populate this table view. We are using this response array. So this is response array. And response array dot count like this, the number of elements which is coming from that response. Now we have to show the values also via that response array. Index path dot row. So this will get the object of response array. Now we have to access the key. So for this dot id, so we are going to show the id over here, and in this we are going to show the title, response array index part dot row dot title, like this thing. Now we can we are good to go, and by running this thing we are going to see that how it is working. So it's showing an error that id is an integer type, so you can typecast this thing, or you, I'm going to use another key. So we are going to use both the things are id, so let's use id over here, dot id. So just simply put this thing in this string object. Now let's run this thing. So whatever the response is, still it's showing an error, it's an optional type. So let's provide a default value to this thing, or we can say that optional value. So now let's run this thing and check that it is working fine or not. So just click on this play button, but the data is not loaded yet. So let me check. Okay, I guess the method is like it is a get method. So just change this method to get, and maybe if there is any kind of problem in this decoding strategy, so that we can get this thing via printing error. So simply just print over here, print error dot localized description, this thing. So if there is any issue in this decoding, then it will throw an error, then we're going to know about the error. So we have to do this thing also. So now let's run this thing and check that it is now working fine or not. So the data is loaded now, and it is showing the first value is an ID which we have provided over here, and the second thing in title. So the MVC pattern is quite simple, and we have to follow this pattern. We can also customize the MVC according to our own need, and it's totally depend on us how we want to implement these things. So this is for today. If you like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button, and if you are new to the channel, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to get the notifications of all my other videos. Meet you in the next video. Thank you.